Hello, welcome to Expert Village. My name is Wayne Petersen, and I'm the director of the Important Bird Areas Program for the Massachusetts Audubon Society. Today, we're here at the Daniel Webster Wildlife Sanctuary in Marshfield, and we're going to be talking about birding by ear. Probably one of the most interesting song types is that exhibited by bird species that are mimics. Some birds that are often kept as cage birds, like the mina birds from Asia, are capable of imitating human vocalizations, and certainly parrots can in fact be taught to speak. But in the wild, probably of all our North American mimics, the Northern Mockingbird is the one that's most famous. Mockingbirds have the ability to incorporate all manner of other bird sounds into their repertoire, and in some cases will actually pick up and mimic mechanical sounds of things that they hear in their surroundings. Now, the evolution of mimicry is an interesting topic, but one of the things that is certainly known about it is that for those species that are mimics, it is highly adaptive behavior in that those males that are able to incorporate the richest repertoire of imitations generally are the most successful breeders. So that clearly one of the adaptive functions of mimicry is to make the males, the ones that in fact do the singing, that much more attractive by having more complex imitations and vocalizations within their repertoire. Now, mockingbirds, like most mimics, also have certain sounds that are quintessential mockingbird, but it's the add-ons that really are the important components.